knows my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now.
There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now.
I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean
just to be with you and fix what I've broken.
Oh, 'cause I need you to see you are the reason.
There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason my heart keeps bleeding. I need you now.
If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every
to love you. It's the best thing that I'll ever do. I get to love you. It's a promise I'm making to you. Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you, I get to love you. The way you love, it changes who I am.
You may be seated. Folks, we're gathered here on this beautiful afternoon to witness the marriage of Matt and Amanda, to ask God to bless them, They've invited us here to share in their public declaration of a lifelong commitment to one another. Marriage, just like our creation, owes its existence to God. It's His will and purpose that a husband and wife should love each other for as long as they both shall live. Marriage is a joyous occasion. We're going to celebrate tonight. But it's also a very serious responsibility, and therefore should never be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully, reverentially, and with mutual respect. And so, Matt, do you take Amanda to be your wife? Do you commit yourself to love her and cherish her above all others as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Amanda, do you take this handsome but nervous groom to be your husband? Do you commit yourself to love him and cherish him above all others as long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right. Who gives this lovely bride to be married to this man?
Her mother, Tammy, my son, Dustin, and I.
Great.
Love you. Kelly.
Folks, let me just turn them to you and say, don't they make a great couple together, folks? There's a lot of planning that has gone into this, and having lived here for 42 years and done a lot of weddings, I can honestly say, even though it's a little breezy, this is beautiful weather. If it's in the 90s, we'd all be suffering. So this is great. We're here to celebrate. It's going to go good. Matt and Amanda have known each other for approximately 2 years. Their first date, I asked Matt, and it was at a barbecue put on by Matt's parents. Whatever they served must have gone well. They hit it off. They had the right connection because they started dating thereafter. And I asked Matt when he proposed, and he said it was last December, this past December, that he proposed. I said, did she say immediately yes, or did she leave you hanging? And she said, she took mercy on me and said yes. So here they are today, and we're going to do the most important part of any wedding ceremony, and that is the exchanging of vows. We're going to begin with you, Matt, if you'll repeat after me. I, Matt, take you, Amanda, to be my wife.
I, Matt, take you, Amanda, to be my wife.
I promise before God, our family, and friends.
I promise before God, our family, and friends.
To be your faithful husband.
Your faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
On this day, I pledge my life to you.
On this day, I pledge my life to you.
Okay. Amanda, are you ready?
Ready.
If you'll repeat after me. I, Amanda, take you, Matt, to be my husband.
I, Amanda, take you, Matt, to be my husband.
I promise before God, our family, and friends.
I promise before God, our family, and our friends.
To be your faithful wife.
To be your faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
On this day, I pledge my life to you.
On this day, I pledge my life to you.
Well, Matt and Amanda, before I pronounce you husband and wife, I want to share with you and everyone here, all of your guests and family, three keys to a happy marriage. God's goal for you is not just to start strong, it's to finish strong. Not just to fall in love, but to stay in love through the years together. And for that to happen, I just want to encourage you to consider three C's. It's easy to remember because they each begin with the letter C. And the first C of a key to a happy marriage is to have Christ at the center. He loves you. He wants to build your love for each other and your family together. And it is so true that the family that prays together stays together. So I want to encourage you both to nurture your relationship with Him. Mm-hmm. He will guide you through the years, the ups and the downs, and help you to stay together. So remember that. Keep Christ at the center. You'll never, ever regret it.
Yeah, He is.
Great. The second C is commitment. Love is not so much an emotion that goes up and down, is here today and gone tomorrow. Love is a commitment. It's a choice you make to treat that other person with kindness and dignity and respect, to honor your partner, to not yell or swear at them. You make that covenant right now that we're not going to treat each other that way. We're going to honor each other. So remember the commitment, the vows you made today, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health, for as long as we both shall live. That's a commitment. So honor those commitments you're making today. Okay. The third C is communication. Every couple here knows the importance of communication, talking things through. You may not always agree, but it's important to stay in the process. Yes. And to continue to communicate, make decisions together. And if you get upset, and it's going to happen, when you get upset at each other, just resolve that you're going to make up before bedtime. The Bible says, be angry. There's going to be times when you're angry, but don't sin. And don't let that sun go down on your anger. So always remember to kiss and make up before bedtime. Don't go to bed angry at each other. Hopefully you won't have to practice this tonight, but there will come a time when you'll need to remember that. Matt and Amanda, my hope for both of you is something that Robert Browning Jr., a poet, said over a century ago. He said, grow old with me because the best is yet to be. And may that be your experience as the years go by. The best continues to be. May I see the bride's ring, please? It's a beautiful ring. It's worn on Amanda's finger as a testimony that she is committed to Matt. It's made of permanent material, indicating the permanency of the commitment, the bond they're making together. And so, Matt, if you'll take this ring, place it on your bride's finger. We have a short ring vow. Amanda, I give you this ring.
Amanda, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love for you.
As a sign of my love for you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
Okay. So now I can see the ring for Matt. Amanda, if you'll take this ring and place it on Matt's finger, and we have the same ring vow, if you'll repeat that. Matt, I give you this ring.
Matt, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love for you.
As a sign of my love for you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
With all that I have.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
You got it on. That's great. There we go. Success.
Sit on it.
Well, we have a special song that Matt and Amanda has chosen, and we've got some roses back here, so I'm going to step aside. The music's going to begin, and enjoy this moment together.
How long will I love you? Stars above you, and longer if I can. How long will I need you? As long as the seasons need to follow their plan.
Folks, you're probably not going to find a prettier evening and venue site than right here. As I look out here on this lake, it's just gorgeous. And in honor of Matt and Amanda, I'd like to ask us to pray. Let's bow our heads and we'll ask God's blessing on their marriage. Father, we thank you that this has all come together to honor them. Thank you for bringing them together. We thank you for their family, that they would just grow in you and be strengthened by you, that you would bless them through the years. You would guide and provide as you do, and that, Father, you would just allow their love to grow stronger for each other through the decades that they share together. We ask God's blessing on this marriage. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, Matt and Amanda, inasmuch as you've exchanged your vows to one another and exchanged rings symbolizing that commitment to each other, it really gives me a great deal of pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as well as by the laws vested in me by this state. Matt, this is the moment you've been waiting for. You may now kiss your bride. So let them get ready for the reception. Let me just say that it gives me a great deal of pleasure to pronounce these words for the first time. I'm happy to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Amanda Webb!
Yes.
Folks, I want to thank you for coming. A wedding is a celebration. We're going to go celebrate. And so if you'll take the trolley on down, Matt and Amanda are going to take some pictures and they'll soon join us. God bless you. Thank you so much for coming.